I salute Donald Trump for focusing on the need to address illegal immigration. The Washington cartel doesn't want to address that. He has a colorful way of speaking. It's not the way I speak, but I'm not going to engage in the media's game of throwing rocks and attacking other Republicans. I'm just not going
to
do it.
So Senator Ted Cruz reacting to Donald Trump's recent comments on Mexican immigrants, and it's one of the hotter topics on the trail right now. New Jersey Governor Chris Christie is one of those candidates. He wants to be president. He's in studio now. Good morning to you, Governor.
Bill, good
thanks
to be
for
here.
Coming back here in America's Newsroom. Hope your family had a great 4th of July
weekend. We did.
And I know you were in New Hampshire over the weekend. We're going to get to all that. Donald Trump is forcing this conversation on immigration. Do you support what he said?
No, I think what he said was wrong. I think it was inappropriate. I don't think it has any place in the campaign. And I find it ironic, right, that Ted Cruz is giving lectures on Republican violence. The guy who put together a group that was sponsoring primary ads against Senator Lamar Alexander is giving us, the rest of us, lectures on Republican violence. I mean, all due respect, I don't need to be lectured by Ted Cruz.
So no lectures from Ted Cruz. Is that the direction in which this is going? Republicans reacting to Republicans, and then there is maybe not blood on the floor, but a little bit of bruising along the way.
I don't think that's where it is yet. I mean, listen, Donald made some comments that I think those of us who have feelings about it reacted to. I think that's what he would expect. He tries to evoke reaction. That's part of who Donald is. I've known him for a long time, and I consider him a good friend. But on this one, we disagree. I think those comments are inappropriate. And I think when you're running for president, you have an obligation to answer some of that stuff, and we do.
Do you have a problem with Ted Cruz?
I don't know. I don't have a problem with him. I disagree with him about him lecturing about Republican on Republican violence. This is a guy who sponsored primary ads against sitting Republican United States senators, and one, quite frankly, that I admire a great deal, like Lamar Alexander. So, you know, let's just not be hypocritical. Okay, don't lecture as to Donald Trump, but then attack Lamar Alexander. Mm. So, you know, all I want is a little consistency.
Just back to the question, though. Is this where it's leading? Where you're a month away from a debate in Cleveland, Ohio, and you're going to have Republicans reacting to Republicans. I mean, it's your position and your stances against the rest of the field in this case.
Well, it's a competition, right, Bill? I mean, all the people that you have up on the screen, all the folks who are running for president, all want to be the nominee. So there's going to be competition. There are going to be differences of opinion. But that doesn't have to resort to violence. And I don't think that anything anybody has said in response to Donald's comments or to anybody else's comments that you disagree with has represented Republican on Republican violence. When you're trying to take out a fellow colleague in the United States Senate in a primary, I'd say that's a little more violent.
Rick Perry said he was offended by what Donald Trump's saying. Do you take offense?
No, I just disagree. I mean, I disagree. I think it's inappropriate. But I'm not personally offended. I think it's inappropriate and nothing I would ever say. But, you know, it doesn't rise to that level.
Here is what Jeb Bush had to say. I think he was also in New Hampshire over the weekend, too, on this same topic.
He's doing this to inflame and to incite and to get to draw attention, which is seems to be his organizing principle of his campaign. And he doesn't represent the Republican Party or its values.
I think there's a bigger issue, and that goes to how Republicans attract more Hispanics. And what does this debate do to that effort, do you believe?
I don't think it does much of anything to it. And listen, I'm somebody...
Does it hurt or help?
I don't think it hurts or helps. I think it's a small moment that we're all emphasizing right now because there's nothing else to emphasize at the moment that will be long gone by the time we get to a general election campaign. You know, and take this from somebody who comes from the most ethnically diverse state in the country, in New Jersey, and who won 51% of the Hispanic vote in 2013 for re-election. I know how to discuss these issues and how to listen, more importantly, to the Latino community in our country about the things that they care about, and that's the way we build a more inclusive Republican Party.
Let's do